I think the thing that was really interesting for me that I didn't see coming was also being informed by the ants and seeing how the ants labor, you know, the work that they're doing, and thinking about the scale of work that they're doing and the repetition in their work and how that relates to my work founded in fibers.
I'm Gabrielle Duggan, I'm an artist.
I'm Adrian Smith, I'm a biologist, and we're here to talk about art and science collaboration, and specifically the piece that we collaborated on in my lab at the North Carolina Museum of Natural Sciences, dealing with ant nest architecture.
Right.
And the processes of art and science, really. So you went out in the field with us to make the cast of the
right.
ant nest that's incorporated in your piece. That's one of the coolest parts of doing research. My sort of research is that, like, we can go out into a forest, like, pour a bunch of dental plaster down a hole that's like this size, right? And then we come out with, like, this crazy complex, like, structure
right.
that these animals have built that it was completely outside of our view before that.
It's pretty hard labor to excavate this nest mm-hmm. and to go out there, find the nest, and then set everything up. That's stuff that you would never see in that piece
yeah.
that's upstairs. So
right.
that's something that I relate to the ants with, is labor.
Mm-hmm.
And labor plays into fiber work specifically a lot, and also people's perceptions of art as a whole. People are always impressed by more labor.
You constructed the piece in the lab. The experiments that I've done in the lab while you've been there is basically shown that whatever hypothesis I thought might be working probably isn't working.
Right.
And so that sort of stuff is process research for me, in that it might not even end up in the final product in the, you know, scientific paper that I write.
Yes, there's a lot of invisible work. I've been thinking about invisible work a lot, and that so much time put into all the work around the work, all the work that supports the capital W work. The stuff that I'm doing, the piece that we have in the lab right now, technically the textile method that's involved is crochet. Even though it's using a crochet stitch to make this weird web effect, I absolutely couldn't do it without being a weaver, which is a completely different process and has a lot of, like, prep work going into it. And so it's my knowledge of having that prep work as a weaver is the thing that lets me work with tension like this on the fly. But you don't see that. You would never think weaver, I'm not weaving. But that knowledge and years of experience with weaving is now showing up and being there for me.
Well, it was awesome to have you in the lab. It's exciting to have something to show after that, and that will live on, at least for a little bit, in the lab.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.